હલ ઠીક હલ
Thank you.
alcohol vachu
Thank you.
A very good evening and a warm welcome to one and all gathered here at the grand opening of the Matheletics first international competition for Maths Pirates. It is indeed a spectacular occasion where numbers meet passion and puzzles ignite intellect. Please join me in extending a heartfelt welcome to our esteemed chief guest for the evening, respected Professor Jay Prakash Pandey, Honorable Vice Chancellor, APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, Lucknow, whose presence adds a remarkable level of gravitas to our gathering. I'm glad to extend a cordial welcome to the visionary minds behind this esteemed event, our respected founder manager, Sir Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, a special mention to the vulnerable principals of various campuses of City Montessori School and HODs, whose unwavering support remains the backbone of our educational fraternity. We are glad to have with us an assembly of some of the most brilliant minds across the globe, the principals, directors, team leaders, and participants of our international and national teams. Your journey to the stage is an achievement in itself, and we applaud your passion and commitment. Today, we converge in the healthy spirit of competition, fostering togetherness and exchanging knowledge across the borders. Our goal is not only to identify the champions among us, but to cultivate our love for mathematics that transcends the traditional boundaries of the classroom. We aim to inspire innovation, celebrate determination, and encourage the fearless exploration of the quantifiable challenges. We are here to learn from each other, to push our limits, and to revel in the sheer joy that mathematics can provide. As we embark on the cerebral voyage, let us embrace the spirit of the Matheletics International event, remembering that each one of us is a variable contributing to the equation of this phenomenal gathering. So once again, welcome to all, and may the best mathematicians thrive. And let this journey begin. But before we dive into the numbers and nurture our love for mathematics, let's take a moment to pause and connect with something greater than ourselves. It's time to join our hearts and minds in the prayer, paying homage to the divine and seeking blessings for a successful event. And to highlight the significance of this moment, I did like to share simple, a yet profound quote. And highlight the significance of this moment, I did like to share a profound quote by Mahatma Gandhi. Prayer is the key of the morning and the bolt of the evening. This teaches us that prayer not only unlocks the day ahead, but also secures the thoughts and actions we leave behind at night. So with this thought, let us pray together with sincerity and hope.
Oh my God, that thou hast the lamp of my heart and make me a brilliant star. Thou art the mighty and the powerful. Thou art the mighty and the powerful. Thou art the mighty and the powerful.
We are thankful to the Almighty for gathering us together under one roof and granting us the opportunity to celebrate our shared passion for mathematics. It is with God's grace that we embark upon this event, and we are hopeful for its fruitful outcome. I trust that a collective prayer has enveloped us in a sense of peace and unity, preparing us for the exciting journey ahead.
Esteemed guests and vibrant participants, we welcome you to an extraordinary event where talent, diversity, and team spirit converge to celebrate not just competition, but the enduring spirit of unity and education. Let us witness the procession and meet our participating teams. I now request our respected chief guest, respected Dr. Jay Prakash Pandey, and our respected founder manager, sir, Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, to please receive the guard of honor. I request the staff to please escort sir on the stage. I request you all to please clap out loudly for them. The audience, please put your hands together to welcome them, as their presence has made this day even more special. And from the periphery of our vision, we catch a glimpse of the procession heading. The audience, please put your hands together for our principal and the convener of Matheletics, first international competition for Maths Pirates, Mrs. Anupama Checker, who is leading the procession with the globe signifying peace and unity. The procession with the globe is to spread the message that the world is but one country and mankind its citizens. So we must arise and awake and be aware of one world, one governance, one judiciary, spreading the message through the motto Jai Jagat across society. So put your hands together once again for the future torch bearers who are following the procession. Let us develop our children such that they become an asset not only for our families, but to become asset for the entire world. Clap out loudly for our future torch bearers. The audience, please clap loudly for our respected principal, Mrs. Anupama Checker. Today we are graced by the presence of the outstanding teams. Here are the international teams: Sangamitra Balika Vidyalay, Vakwela Road, Sri Lanka; Sangamitra Balika Vidyalay, Kali Campus, Sri Lanka; Vidyaloka College, Vakwali and Kali Campus, Bangladesh; Scholastica Senior Campus and Meetpur Campus, Bangladesh; St. Gregory's High School and College, Municipal Office Street Campus and Lakshmi Bazaar Campus, Bangladesh; Sunrise Public Secondary School, Nepal; Hathosa Little Star English Boarding Secondary School, Banganga Campus and Odari Campuses, Nepal. The audience, please give them a huge round of applause. We have Sri Annapurna Vidya Mandir Secondary School from Nepal. We request all to give a huge round of applause for our national teams. Sri Adarsh Vidyalay Gujarat, Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Hing Gangghat, Maharashtra, Delhi Public School, Bhopal, Rustam Ji International School, Mohadi Campus, Maharashtra, Rustam Ji International Schools, Shirsoli Road Campus, Maharashtra, Rustam Ji International School, Jalgaon Campus, Maharashtra. Following them are the Aryan International School, Varanasi, BCM Arya Model Senior Secondary School, Ludhiana, Punjab, Lord Ganesha English School, Janmer, Maharashtra, JC's Public School, Rudrapur, Uttarakhand, BCM Arya International School, Ludhiana, Punjab, JB Academy, Ayodhya, UP, Moonland International School, Amethi, UP. The audience, you are requested to please give them a huge round of applause. They have crossed borders, they have come from different cities, states, all to represent their talent, their enthusiasm for mathematics. We welcome you all. We have the Gurukul Academy, Palyakala, Kheri, UP. Following them are the Ajmani International School, Lakhimpur Kheri, UP. Following them are the Sri Sai Inter College, Barabanki, UP. SD Memorial Playway School, Ayodhya, UP. Who are followed by St. Kabir Public School, Chandigarh. We now have Dalem Sunbeam School, Varanasi. PB Academic School, Kolkata. And Global Indian International School, Bangalore. And in our very own backyard, we are honored by the presence of our local teams. The heartbeat of them, here comes St. M.R. Jaipuria School, Lucknow, followed by Vishwanath Academy, Dhawapur Campus, Lucknow, and Vishwanath Academy, Ashiana Campus, Lucknow. Following them are the Coors Global School, Lucknow, Delhi Public School, Lucknow, City International School, Lucknow, and here are our students presenting all the campuses of City Montessori School, Lucknow. Ladies and gentlemen, this procession was a glimpse of all the buzzing and enthusiasm that we are going to experience in the next 3 days. We are gathered here today in the spirit of inquiry and enlightenment for a very special session of the World Parliament, a confluence of mathematics and spirituality. Today, we embark on a cerebral adventure to explore the intricate tapestry woven by the threads of mathematics and spirituality. A symposium where intellect meets introspection and numbers converse with the nonsense of the spirit. Our students who stand at the vanguard of this exploration are all set to unveil the mystic connections that bind the logical rigor of mathematics with the abstract realms of spirituality. It's a discourse that dwells into the sacred geometry and patterns, our very existence and divine ratios that govern the cosmos. Moreover, these young mathematicians will elucidate how both mathematics and spirituality guide us towards the universal truth, be it through the ethereal beauty of a fractal or the silent resonance of a meditation.
In the realm of numbers, where equations unfold, mathematics weaves virtues worth more than gold. It ignites curiosity, sparks a quest for truth, engenders discipline, a resolute salute to calculations and patterns. It fosters precision, nurturing skills and igniting ambition. Mathematics lessons unfold, a poetic tapestry of truth untold. From right angles, balance, harmony springs, guiding our choices on fair just wait. Acute angles teach humility's grace to embrace new ideas our minds embrace. Obtuse angles bridge diverse views, a middle ground to find, understanding pursue. Straight angles speak of integrity true, staying authentic in all we do. Complementary and supplementary angles combining collaborations key. Parallel lines steadfast and strong in life to our values we belong. Intersecting lines, harmony they show. Balancing relationships, togetherness we sow. Vertically opposite angles make us see. Connected we are, how actions can be. Leadership emerges where logic takes flight. Maths, a symphony, composing minds bright.
Taking a deep dive, we start MAT, a key to unlock the spiritual heart. Numbers in MAT, sacred they stand, they power felt across every land.
Life's pattern through Fibonacci we trace, growth and evolution in its rhythmic pace, a stunning sight, our spiritual quest. Through mathematics, it's truly blessed.
Next, we see truth's pursuit unfold. In math, it's logic we hold. Amidst life's chaos, math brings order, guiding our search as a trusted supporter.
Continuing our path, we give it due. Math's role in unity, valued and true. No matter the language, math stays the same, fostering oneness in spirituality's game.
Transcendence is beauty, we explore. With math, we open this magical door. The golden ratio in nature, it's clear. Math makes our spirituality dear.
Thus, our spiritual journey finds its zen in the wondrous world of mathematics. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed guests, and fellow seekers of knowledge, I extend a very warm welcome to this special parliament. Today, we have gathered here to discuss a fascinating and thought-provoking topic: the unexpected intersection between mathematics and spirituality. While the two realms may seem worlds apart, a closer examination reveals intriguing connections that broaden our understanding of both. For instance, one is the first whole number above zero and is not only used to count, it also has a special meaning, which is to express the concept of oneness or singleness. Oneness implies unity and agreement. When someone says we are one, he or she is talking about being in harmony with others. We must always remember that irrespective of all our minute differences, humanity is one, and we must live as a family unit.
While mathematicians are typically known for their focus on logic, reason, and empirical evidence, There have been instances where mathematicians have explored topics related to spirituality or expressed philosophical views that touch on spiritual themes. Let us embark on a journey that delves into the mysteries of mathematics and its potential to awaken our spiritual consciousness. So, today we will be discussing about role of mathematics in discovering patterns of spiritual life. Role of mathematics in the quest for truth. Mathematics fostering a sense of unity in diversity, and mathematics transcending aesthetic beauty.
Mathematics is a language of patterns. How does it unravel the hidden symmetries and rhythms that permeate our universe? The house is open for discussion. Member nations are requested to raise their placards. Member nation Germany, you are recognized. You may please take the floor.
Thank you, ma'am. Mathematics encompasses the study of symmetry, which is a fundamental concept found in various aspects of nature and human creation. Symmetry can be observed in the arrangement of petals in a flower, the structure of snowflakes, or the proportions in a work of art. These symmetries can be seen as reflections of deeper spiritual patterns and principles of balance and harmony.
Ma'am, with your kind permission, I would like to add something relevant to the topic.
Member Nation Nigeria, you are most welcome to share your views.
Thank you, ma'am. Numerology, the study of the occult significance of numbers, draws on mathematical principles to interpret and assign meaning to numbers. Different cultures and spiritual traditions have attributed symbolic significance to various numbers, considering them to represent specific qualities or energies. Numerology explores patterns and relationships between numbers to uncover hidden meanings and insights into spiritual aspects of life.
It's important to note that mathematics can provide perspectives and frameworks for exploring patterns in spirituality. In contemplating these patterns, we cannot help but sense a deeper, transcendent presence, a spiritual dimension that speaks to the interconnectedness of all things.
Mathematics is a relentless pursuit of truth and certainty. Would anyone like to elaborate this valuable thought? The House recognizes Member Nation Argentina to put forward your views. The floor is all yours.
Thank you, ma'am. Mathematics has deep connections to philosophical inquiries about the nature of truth, knowledge, and reality. Questions about the nature of numbers, the limits of knowledge, and the existence of mathematical objects have sparked philosophical debates throughout history. Mathematics provides a framework for exploring these fundamental questions and contributes to the philosophical understanding of truth and knowledge.
Well said, Member Nation Argentina. Just as spiritual seekers yearn for knowledge and enlightenment, mathematicians seek the eternal truths that underlie the fabric of mathematics itself. But it's important to note that while mathematics is a powerful tool for seeking truth, it is not the sole arbiter of truth. It serves as a valuable methodology, but it must be complemented by other forms of inquiry, such as empirical observation, critical thinking, and interdisciplinary approaches.
Mathematics is often referred to as a universal language because its principles and concepts are not bound by cultural or linguistic barriers. How does this universality of mathematics allow people from diverse backgrounds to share and collaborate on mathematical ideas, fostering a sense of unity? Member nations, you may please raise your placards to share your opinion. Member nation India, you are recognized. You may please take the floor.
Thank you, ma'am. Mathematics provides a common ground for individuals with diverse perspectives to engage in meaningful discourse. Mathematical reasoning and proof provide an objective framework for evaluating ideas and arguments. By focusing on mathematical concepts and principles, people can set aside personal biases and cultural differences, promoting a shared pursuit of truth and understanding.
Member Nation Russia, it seems you want to share something. You may please take the floor.
Thank you, ma'am. Mathematics itself encompasses a vast array of branches, theories and mathematical objects. The diversity within mathematics reflects the diversity of human thoughts and creativity. Different mathematical concepts and approaches offer a unique perspectives and insights, enriching the mathematical landscape and promoting a sense of unity towards the appreciation of diverse mathematical ideas.
Truly said, Member Nation Russia, mathematics reveals the hidden unity amidst the diversity of mathematical concepts. It uncovers the intricate relationships between seemingly unrelated ideas, unifying them under a common framework.
Mathematics possesses an undeniable aesthetic quality, an elegance and simplicity that captivate the human mind. Let us now ponder upon what role is mathematics play in transcending aesthetic beauty by providing a framework for understanding and appreciating the underlying structures and patterns that contribute to beauty. Member Nation Sri Lanka, you are recognized. You may please take the floor.
Thank you, ma'am. I believe that mathematics, particularly the study of symmetry and proportions, reveal the inherent order and harmony in aesthetic forms. Concepts such as the golden ratio, Fibonacci sequence, and fractals provide mathematical principles that are often associated with beauty. Understanding these mathematical relationships deepen our appreciation of aesthetic objects, whether they are found in nature, art, or design.
Ma'am, with the kind permission, I would like to add something to what my friend has just shared.
Member Nation Mexico, you are welcome to share your thoughts.
Thank you, ma'am. Mathematics itself is a source of beauty. Mathematicians appreciate the elegance, simplicity, and aesthetic qualities through mathematical proofs, theorems, and equations. The beauty of mathematics lies in its abstract concepts and logical structures, which can evoke a sense of awe and wonder. By exploring the beauty of mathematics, individuals can develop a deeper appreciation for aesthetic beauty in general.
It is noteworthy that mathematics offers a lens through which we can explore and transcend the boundaries of aesthetics, opening up new avenues for creativity, understanding, and awe-inspiring experiences. By delving into mathematical principles, patterns, and concepts, we can transcend conventional notions of aesthetics and deepen our appreciation of the inherent harmony and complexity present in the world. Mathematics has been so far used to formulate and solve the physical scientific problems very precisely and accurately. But by drawing the parallelism between mathematics and the inner existence of life, it is amply shown how mathematical concepts can be used to teach the values in life and subsequently give solution to lead a happy and purposeful life.
As I conclude this exploration of the connection between mathematics and spirituality, I invite you to reflect upon the profound implications of this unlikely alliance. Mathematics, with its patterns, truth-seeking, symbolism, and transcendent beauty, has the power to awaken our spiritual consciousness. By embracing on both the rational and mystical, we can embark on a remarkable journey, one that unites the logical and spiritual realms, expanding our horizons, enriching our lives. Thank you, and may your explorations of both mathematics and spirituality bring you closer to the profound implications that lie within and beyond our reach. The Parliament session is hereby formally closed. We will have our next session on 1st December 2024. Till then, goodbye to all.
The audience, they definitely deserve a louder round of applause. What a journey we have traversed today at the World Parliament. We have witnessed the convergence of logic and faith, calculations and contemplation through the inside deliberations of these young participants. A heartfelt congratulations to each participant for presenting such a thoughtful session. We now understand that mathematics, often perceived as the language of the universe, is intrinsically linked to the spiritual journey of seeking meaning beyond the material. We acknowledge that patterns, numbers, and shapes transcend merely practically. They also symbolize a cosmic dance that aligns with the rhythms of the soul. Now, as we gear up for an event that promises to be both enlightening and inspiring, we will first commence the proceedings with the words of our guiding force. With great pleasure, I invite to the stage a person of immense integrity and wisdom. She is the torchbearer of knowledge and an inspiration for us. Her commitment towards nurturing young minds is unparalleled, and her dedication is nothing short of extraordinary. Please join me in welcoming our respected and esteemed principal, ma'am, respected Mrs. Anupama Chekhar to please deliver her welcome address and set the perfect tone for what is bound to be a remarkable event.
Good evening and Jai Jagat to all. It is indeed a moment of great joy and excitement for me as we gather here today to inaugurate a pioneering event of our esteemed institution, Matheletics, the first international competition for math pirates. Just clap loudly for the competition. Yeah. Because this competition marks the beginning of a transformative journey, promising to reshape our perceptions and engagements with the fascinating world of mathematics. Mathematics is often regarded as a subject which stirs mixed emotion. Some embrace it enthusiastically and others finding it challenging. So today we are here to challenge those preconceptions. We aim to demonstrate that mathematics is not merely a subject for study. It is an adventure waiting to be explored, an ocean of possibilities, where equations are treasures waiting to be explored. Mathematics transcends the traditional approach of solving problems on paper. It's about transforming mathematics into an exhilarating experience, a voyage that combines logic, creativity, and sense of adventure. Our theme, Where Math is Fun, underscores the idea that mathematics is not confined to dull calculations. It's a playground of ideas, a realm where every solution is a triumph and every problem is a puzzle waiting to be solved. As a mathematics teacher myself, I feel that mathematics is more than just a subject. It's a critical discipline that teaches various life skills and ways of thinking that can be applied in many aspects of life. Thus, it helps a disciplined approach to solving problems in a logical way of thinking that transcends the subject itself, providing lifelong skills that are applicable in many different situations. Recently, we witnessed in the World Parliament how different angles are connected to the spirituality in our lives. Mathematics too brings discipline to life and impart valuable life lessons. You will witness this connection in some of our upcoming programs. It's an honor to have here with us today Professor Jay Prakash Pandeyji, Vice Chancellor, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh. Sir, your presence has added immense prestige and significance to our event. As your distinguished chief guest, your accomplishments and contributions have inspired many, and we are truly privileged to have you join us today. Your presence not only elevates the importance of the occasion, but also serves as a source of motivation for everyone present here. We are eager to benefit from your insights and wisdom as we embark on this memorable journey. Once again, thank you for gracing the occasion. Yes, we should clap loudly for the chief guest because he has to go to some place and he cancelled that and he came to our event. So I'm really thankful, sir. I extend a warm welcome to all the directors, principals, team leaders, and participants from 12 international, 22 national, and 27 local teams. Your presence adds a global dimension to our event, and we are honored to have you on contribute to the celebration of mathematical excellence. In absentia, I would like to thank all the respected senior principals, respected HODs, and my dear friends from different CMS campuses. They are still on the way because since morning, they were there at Gomtinagar 2. The meritorious function for class 12 was going on. You all know that after every pre-boards, sir had that meritorious function to honor the children who get some prizes, and then the analysis was done. So all the principals were there, and from directly there, from there, they are coming to join us in the evening. So I just want to thank them if they are seeing me from anywhere, from YouTube or wherever. To the participants, I encourage you to approach each challenge with the spirit of curiosity and the joy of discovery. Remember, this competition is not just finding out the right answers. It's about relishing the process, embracing the patterns, and celebrating the beauty of mathematics. I express my gratitude to the respected founders of City Montessori School, Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, Dr. Mrs. Bharti Gandhi, Managing Director and President, Professor Geeta Gandhi Kingdon, Head QAID and Superior Principal, Ms. Sushmita Ghosh, for their continuous support and guidance. I stand before you today imbued with both pride and gratitude as I recall about the extraordinary journey of Matheletics, the birth and blossoming of Matheletics. It was once merely a figment of my imagination. Today it stands as a testament to the unwavering support of our respected founders, Managing Director and Head QAID. I take this opportunity to thank you once again for all your guidance and support. I also thank my team of staff, students, and also the parents. Yes, parents, I would like to clap for you. Yes. For unyielding spirit that they have had, and what you all have supported to us as a junior campus. It's difficult for us to take such a big initiative, but it's all your support and all your trust on us. I also extend my sincere thanks to my teachers who have worked tirelessly and passionately for the event. Dear teachers, I'm confident that this competition will be a testament to your hard work. The ethos of Matheletics is rooted in a single seed, meticulously nurtured in every team member's perseverance, creativity, and collective approach. We have toiled through the seasons of challenge and triumph, and what you witness today is more than an event. It is the physical manifestation of a vision that was lovingly cultivated over the past year, yet it took past 1 year to plan and to execute this. Before our chief guest officially declares the event open, I request everyone to immerse themselves in the world of numbers, equations, and mathematical wonders for today. Let the journey begin, and may the spirit of sportsmanship guide us all to new horizons of knowledge and excitement. May this competition be a memorable and joyous experience for each and every one of you. Thank you, and Jai Jagat.
Thank you, ma'am, for these encouraging words. Your insightful speech has indeed set a formidable foundation for the day today. We are immensely grateful for your leadership and unwavering support. Ladies and gentlemen, I request you again to present a huge round of applause for our respected principal, ma'am, as we gear up for the exciting day ahead. You can see them lined up right in front. Yes, it's a moment brimming with melody and innocence as we eagerly anticipate a heartwarming performance from our youngest stars. Today, our Montessori class is here not just to sing, but to sprinkle the magic of their pure voices and fill our hearts with joy. They have been practicing tirelessly, and now the stage is all theirs. So without any further delay, let's give them a warm and rousing welcome to these little cherubs as they come forth to present their choir performance. Prepare to be enchanted by the sweet symphony of our delightful tiny tots. Let's give them a big round of applause. May we please have the music, sir?
God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good. God is good all the time.
God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good. God is good all the time. If you're walking through the valley, there are shadows all around. Do not fear, He will guide you. He will keep you safe and sound. For He has promised to never leave you, nor forsake you. And His word is true. God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good all the time.
One more time.
God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good. He's so good. God is good. He's so good. God is good. He's so good all the time.
Thank you.
What a captivating redemption. Our Montessori class has indeed taken us on this melodious journey. With their angelic voices and synchronized charm, they've lit the stage with luminance of their youthful spirit. They say music is the language of soul, and today these little musicians spoke directly to our hearts. Let's show our appreciation for their amazing talent with another thunderous round of applause. Well done, little ones. Your lovely song has echoed the essence of joy and harmony. Thank you for sharing your gift of music with all of us present today. On to your seats as we're about to dive into a world where numbers come alive. Our next act takes you on a toe-tapping journey through the fascinating land of maths. Are you ready to watch the numbers dance? This drama is not just going to be entertaining, it's going to be a lesson in the virtues that maths teaches us. But before this, we would like to welcome our respected Miss Shushmita Ghosh ma'am, head QAID. She has been coming all the way from Gomti Nagar to campus, which is right on the other end of our city. And to all the respected principals who have joined us, thank you, because your presence definitely was very much needed.
Let's cheer on for our performers who are coming up next as they bring this world of maths on stage before you.
In a world that exists between the pages of mathematics books, where numbers live and dwell, harmony reigned supreme. Numbers coexisted, working together in equations and theorems, aiding in the universe's delicate balance. Against the numbers came forth from the hidden lacuna of the book's corner. She sought to cause chaos, create division among numbers, and exploit their inherent characteristics.
Thank you. The witch stood tall against the white backdrop of the maths world. Her cackling laugh causing the numbers to quiver in apprehension. Her eyes glowed an airy green as she addressed her chosen subject. She chose 9, the most potent among them, to be the instrument of her evil design. The larger numbers started slapping the smaller ones. As this continued, numbers 1 and 2 fearfully looked towards each other. They were the smallest. They did not know what would happen of them. So they went to the number 0.
What are we to do? Can we even stand a chance against such a dark power?
Today, we dare not crumble under such adversity. Remember the power to uplift each other, stronger than any witch spell. Witch, you can cast your dark spells, cause havoc in our peaceful world. But never shall you separate us. We are numbers, unbreakable, united, and eternal. Desolation is not our destiny. We are meant to help rise each other. Numbers, we are not created to pull each other down, but to elevate each other. We each have a unique value, a unique strength that contributes to the harmony of our realm. Our essence is an addition and multiplication, and not division nor degradation. We must understand that our strength lies in standing for each other. Remember, we are not mere digits. We are the creators and holders of this world. Let's not demean each other, but uplift and educate others.
You feeble figures, situated on the lower echelons of this magical world. Dare to challenge my authority. I'll have you dispersed into nullity.
Stand together. Through the challenges faced, we found our way, crafting solutions where there was dismay. A reminder forever in history's gate of our resilience, bold and innate.
Let this day be etched in memory as evidence of our fortitude and ability to create.
Thank you.
other accumulate in separate tests, we do vitiate. Our students have shown us how mathematics is more than just about numbers. It's about uplifting each other, working together, solving problems together. Just like a complex problem, each number plays its important role, and together they create beautiful solutions. Tonight, our performers reminded us that, like in maths, we are together stronger when we support and uplift each other rather than demean and bring each other down. Let's give them a huge round of applause for a show that truly added up to the special meaning of Matheletics. Maths, dear friends, isn't merely a subject. It's a universal language fostering collaboration, inspiring us to uplift one another. We are really glad, as we have been joined by our respected founder director, ma'am, and our respected managing director and president, ma'am. We are so thankful that you took out time from your busy day for us. As we move ahead, I would now request our respected founder manager, sir, respected Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, to please introduce our chief guest for today, Professor Jay Prakash Pandey.
We are extremely honored to welcome our most respected chief guest, Honorable Dr. Jay Prakash Pandey, Vice Chancellor of APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, AKTU of Uttar Pradesh. Mr. Jay Prakash Pandey, the Vice Chancellor of APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, has played a major role in the development of AKTU for the over two decades, serving as the joint controller of examinations, additional controller of examination, controller of examination, and as a member of the most all committees of the universities. He was earlier the vice chancellor of Madan Mohan Malviya University of Technology, Gorakhpur, and professor with the Electrical Engineering Department, Kamala Nehru Institute of Technology, Sultanpur, Uttar Pradesh, India. He also worked as the director of Kamala Nehru Institute of Technology, NIT, Sultanpur. He has more than 30 years of experience in the field of teaching, industry and administration. We are extremely honored to welcome such an outstanding personality and Vice Chancellor of APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, the biggest university of Uttar Pradesh. I also welcome all the respected principals, Mrs. Basu, the head of the Quality Assurance and Innovations Department, Ms. Manjeet Batra, the Superior Senior Most Principal, and Mr. Dr. I welcome all the respected guests, eminent educationists from Bangladesh, from Nepal, from Sri Lanka, and other parts of India. I welcome each one of you, and I welcome all the delegates over 60 teams which are participating in this event.
सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल परिवार हर्ष और गर्व का अनुभव कर रहा है कि इस समारोह के मुख्य अतिथि डॉक्टर एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी के कुलपति प्रोफेसर जयप्रकाश पांडे जी हैं। आपकी पहचान एक जाने माने शिक्षक और प्रशासक के रूप में स्थापित है। आपने डॉक्टर एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी के विकास और प्रसिद्धि में महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभाई है। विश्वविद्यालय की सेवा में लगभग 2 दशक से संलग्न डॉक्टर पांडेय ने गुणवत्तापूर्ण शिक्षा के साथ साथ रिसर्च और इनोवेशन पर सदैव बल दिया है। आपकी रुचि, योग्यता और कौशल को देखते हुए आपको विश्वविद्यालय के ज्वाइंट कंट्रोलर ऑफ एग्जामिनेशन, एडिशनल कंट्रोलर ऑफ एग्जामिनेशन और कंट्रोलर ऑफ एग्जामिनेशन जैसे महत्वपूर्ण और संवेदनशील पदों का दायित्व सौंपा गया। डॉक्टर एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी के कुलपति नियुक्त होने से पूर्व डॉक्टर पांडे मदन मोहन मालवी यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी गोरखपुर के कुलपति और कमला नेहरू इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सुल्तानपुर में प्रोफेसर और निदेशक रह चुके हैं और इन भूमिकाओं में आपने सराहना और ख्याति अर्जित की। टीम भावना और सह अस्तित्व की धारणा के प्रबल पक्षधर प्रोफेसर पांडे अपने साथियों और विद्यार्थियों को हमेशा प्रोत्साहित करते रहते हैं। आपका सानिध्य हमें प्रेरित कर रहा है। हम आपका हार्दिक स्वागत और अभिनंदन करते हैं।
प्रांगण में पधारे हर्षित हैं हम तन मन से जागी हैं भाग्य हमारे आपकी कर्मठता ही बनी है आज आपकी शान आपका स्वागत करने पर हम सबको है अभिमान
आयो रे आयो रे आयो रे आज ये शुभ दिन आयो रे आयो रे आयो रे आज ये शुभ दिन आयो रे छायो रे छायो रे छायो रे
आयो रे आयो रे आज शुभ दिन
ayuri 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 aaji shubh din ayuri 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 aaji shubh din ayuri 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 aaji shubh din ayuri aaji shubh din ayuri aaji shubh din ayuri We are immensely grateful to respected Professor Jayaprakash Pandey sir for gracing us with his presence today. Your support and attendance have added immeasurable prestige to our event. And on behalf of everyone here and the entire organizing committee, I wish to express our most sincere thanks to you. Thank you, sir. Light is the purest form of redemption and the embellishment of our inner peace. It brings with it radiance, positivity, and hope. Let us now light the lamp and pray that it dispels the darkness of ignorance. Happiness can be found even in the darkest of times if one remembers to kindle the light. If there will be light in the soul, there will be beauty in the person. Let us all choose our way away from the darkness and move towards the brighter light. O God, may the divine light illumine all our lives and bless us all. I now request our respected chief guest, our respected founder manager, sir, our respected founder director ma'am, our respected managing director and president ma'am, our respected head QAID, and all respected principals, head of departments, principals of the various teams who have joined us, directors, team leaders, I request all to please join us on the stage for the lamp lighting ceremony. The audience, please give them a huge round of applause.
Love spread far all over the world for peace and harmony. May the Lord keep this light always burning forever and ever.
May this light far, all over the world, for peace and harmony. May the Lord keep this light always burning forever and ever, forever and ever, forever and ever.
Let the light of learning shine so bright that others can see their way out of dark. I request at this moment our respected chief guest to please declare our first International Mathematics Open.
I hereby declare the first International Mathematics 2023 Open.
Audience, please clap out loudly as this was the most awaited part of the evening. Celebrate this momentous occasion, what could be better than to hear it from someone who has achieved greatness through his hard work and dedication? Our respected chief guest for the day, Professor Jay Prakash Pandey, has been a guiding light, inspiring countless individuals to reach for the stars. So I would now invite our chief guest to share his valuable insights with us. Let's give them give him a warm welcome as he grace us with his presence and enlighten us with his wisdom. The audience, you have a role to play. Please clap out loudly for him.
सभी को नमस्कार। सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल के संस्थापक डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी जी एवं डॉक्टर भारती गांधी जी, सीएमएस की प्रेसिडेंट डॉक्टर गीता गांधी किंगडन, विश्वविद्यालय विद्यालय के क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस एंड इनोवेशन विभाग की हेड श्रीमती सुष्मिता बसु, अंतर्राष्ट्रीय गणित महोत्सव मैथमेटिक्स 2023 की कन्वेनर एवं सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल राजाजीपुरम द्वितीय कैंपस की प्रधानाचार्य श्रीमती अनुपमा चेकर जी, विश्वविद्यालय की सभी शाखाओं के प्रधानाचार्य, इस अंतर्राष्ट्रीय गणित महोत्सव में प्रतिभाग कर रहे नेपाल, बांग्लादेश, श्रीलंका और भारत के विभिन्न प्रांतों के पधारे बाल गणितज्ञ, विशेषज्ञ एवं शिक्षकगण, सबसे पहले हम सभी को विश्वविद्यालय की तरफ से अपनी तरफ से आभार प्रकट करता हूँ कि आपने मुझे पहला ये आपका इवेंट है कंपटीशन का मैथमेटिक्स जैसे विषय पर, उसके लिए आपने मुझे आयोजित किया आमंत्रित किया, उसके लिए मैं आपका आभारी हूँ। मुझे हार्दिक प्रसन्नता है कि सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल राजाजीपुरम द्वितीय कैंपस द्वारा इस 4-डे इंटरनेशनल मैथमेटिक्स फेस्टिवल 2023 को ऑर्गेनाइज करने का जो मुख्य उद्देश्य है वो विश्व भर के छात्र छात्राओं में गणित के प्रति रुझान बढ़ाने, छात्रों को गणित का विश्व स्तरीय ज्ञान उपलब्ध कराने एवं उस ज्ञान का उपयोग मानवता के पक्ष में करने के लिए प्रेरित करना है। मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि इस गणित मैथमेटिक्स ओलंपियाड के माध्यम से ये देश विदेश के जो हमारे बाल गणितज्ञ हैं आगे चलकर न केवल विश्व स्तरीय गणितज्ञ ही बनेंगे बल्कि वे अपने ज्ञान का उपयोग भी सारी मानवता की भलाई के लिए करेंगे। हम सभी जानते हैं कि भारत हमेशा से गणित के क्षेत्र में विश्व के देशों का सिरमौर रहा है। मैं कुछ चीज़ें ऐसी बताना चाहता हूँ जो हम लोगों ने अपने स्टडीज़ के ड्यूरेशन में जो फाइंडिंग्स पाई हैं पर्टिकुलरली मैथमेटिक्स के लिए। यहाँ जितने लोग बैठे हुए हैं मैं बताना चाहता हूँ कि जो चीज़ें नेचुरल नहीं हैं, जो इवॉल्व हुई हैं या आदमी ने बनाई है, जो भी इस हाल में जितनी भी चीज़ें दिख रही हैं उन सभी में मैथमेटिक्स का उपयोग किया गया। कोई भी चीज़, अगर आप सोफ़ा आप जिस पे बैठे हुए हैं, जो चेयर बैठे हुए हैं, सबसे पहले किसी भी चीज़ को बनाने के लिए जो भी आपका ये जो फ्रेम दिख रहा है, कैमरा दिख रहा है, इन सब में मैथमेटिक्स का उपयोग है। आपको लगेगा कैसे है मैथमेटिक्स का उपयोग, भगवान ने भी हमारी शरीर बनाई होगी तो निश्चित रूप से इसकी मॉडलिंग जरूर की होगी। जब भी कभी हम इंजीनियरिंग में, जब भी कभी हम मैन्युफैक्चरिंग में कोई भी चीज़ बनाते हैं तो उसका एक मैथमेटिकल मॉडल बनाते हैं, और मैथमेटिकल मॉडल बनाने के बाद जब मैथमेटिकल मॉडल होता है, स्टैंडर्ड मॉडल है, और उसके बाद उनके इक्वेशंस बनाते हैं, उन इक्वेशंस को हम सॉल्व करते हैं, तब सोल्यूशन निकालते हैं। हमें पता होता है इसकी दिस लेंथ इज दिस, विड्थ इज दिस, हाइट इज दिस, और फिर हम उसको सिमुलेट करते हैं जो आपके फॉर्म में आपके सामने ये फ्रेम दिख रहा है। तो कभी भी कोई भी लाइफ में जो भी चीज आप बनाने के लिए आएंगे, यू विल हैव टू गो फॉर द मैथमेटिक मॉडलिंग फर्स्ट। अब मैथमेटिक मॉडलिंग करने के बाद आप उसका सोल्यूशन निकालते हैं। ये तो हमने आपको बताया एडवांस चीजें, लेकिन मैथमेटिक्स पूरे विश्व में प्रैक्टिस की जाती है, स्टडी नहीं की जाती है। आप एक गांव के जो गांव का आदमी बिल्कुल पढ़ा लिखा नहीं है वो भी कहता है, आप उसे कहते हैं 5 रुपए का ये सामान दे दो, 3 दे दो, तो वो मल्टीप्लाई कर लेता है। वो जानता नहीं है मैथमेटिक्स क्या है, उसको मालूम है 5 × 3 = 15 हमको देना है। हम प्रैक्टिस करते हैं मैथमेटिक्स को। मैथमेटिक्स लाइक आज की डेट में इतनी इंपॉर्टेंट है और हम चूंकि बच्चे हैं हमारे कंपटीशन होगा और निश्चित तौर पर मैं इस जो सीएमएस का ये ब्रांच है जिसने ये पहला कंपटीशन शुरू किया है उसको बधाई देना चाहता हूँ कि इतनी अच्छा विषय है ये और इसको कैसे हम इक्वेशंस के फॉर्म में हम बच्चे को बता सकते हैं। हम लोग जब बच्चों को मोटिवेट करते हैं तो हम उनको आइंस्टीन का फार्मूला दिखाते हैं। जितने भी मैथमेटिक्स के लोग हैं फिजिक्स के लोग हैं दे नो फार्मूला ऑफ आइंस्टीन E=mc². हम बच्चे को ये बताते हैं E इज स्टैंड फॉर योर एनर्जी, M इज योर मोटिवेशन लेवल एंड C इज योर कमिटमेंट। अगर आप आइंस्टीन के फार्मूले को अपनी लाइफ में इनकलकेट करिए या स्टूडेंट को इनकलकेट कराइए या किसी भी हमारी लाइफ में भी वही हो सकता है। अब आप ऐसे देखिए, मोटिवेशन लेवल आपका एक हो सकता है, आपके टीचर मोटिवेट करेंगे, आपके पेरेंट्स मोटिवेट करेंगे और आपका और भी लोग जो सोसाइटी के लोग हैं वो मोटिवेट करेंगे। सी इज योर कमिटमेंट। अगर मैथ मोटिवेशन लेवल वन हुआ, कमिटमेंट आपका जो हमारे स्टूडेंट्स हैं, आई वॉन्ट टू से दैट टू देम, मोटिवेशन लेवल इफ इट इज वन, योर ई इज वन। इफ योर मोटिवेशन लेवल इज टू, योर एनर्जी लेवल विल बिकम 4 times। सो लाइफ में जब भी कभी आएगा ये इन जो मैथमेटिक्स का ये इक्वेशन है विच इज ट्रीटेड एज आइंस्टीन इक्वेशन और फेमस है, वो आप अपनी लाइफ में लेके आना। दैट इज योर कमिटमेंट। अगर आपने किसी भी काम को करने के लिए कमिटमेंट आपका बढ़ेगा तो आपका एनर्जी लेवल या जो भी इफिशियंसी लेवल कुछ भी ई को स्टैंड कर सकते हैं हम अपनी लाइफ में, वो आपका इतना टाइम होगा। अगर आपका कमिटमेंट 3 times हुआ तो आपकी एनर्जी लेवल 9 times होने वाली है। दूसरा, जो हम लोगों ने इंजीनियरिंग में जो यहाँ मदर्स बैठी हुई हैं उनके लिए मेरा सजेशन है, कुछ यहाँ डॉक्टर्स भी होंगे, पैथोलॉजिस्ट होंगे, मैं उनको बताना चाहता हूँ। हम लोगों ने, जब मैं वाइस चांसलर था मदन मोहन मालवीय टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी में, तो हमारी जो ऑनरेबल गवर्नर मैडम है उन्होंने हम लोगों को टास्क दिया कि हम लोग 5 गाँव को अडॉप्ट किए हुए थे गोरखपुर में, हमने 5 गाँव में हमारे जो टीचर्स हैं स्टूडेंट हैं जो बीटेक पढ़ने वाले लड़के आए थे वो जाते थे स्कूलों में जाके पढ़ाते थे। जो प्राइमरी स्कूल है वहाँ पे मैथमेटिक्स का अच्छा टीचर नहीं मिलता है, फिजिक्स का अच्छा टीचर नहीं मिलेगा, साइंस का अच्छा और नहीं, केमिस्ट्री का नहीं मिलेगा, तो ये लड़के सैटरडे और संडे को वहाँ जाते थे गाँव में पढ़ने के लिए, लड़कियाँ भी जाती थी। हम लोगों ने गांव में एनालिसिस कराई, मैडम ने कहा, गवर्नर मैडम ने, कि आप ये एनालिसिस करो कि हमारी जो गांव की महिलाएं हैं वो कितनी एनेमिक हैं। आप सरप्राइज करेंगे डेटा, 68% गांव की जो महिलाएं हैं वो एनेमिक हैं। अब इसको क्यों मैं यहां जोड़ रहा हूं मैं आपको बताना चाहता हूं, मैथमेटिक्स सीधा इससे जुड़ा हुआ है। अगर डॉक्टर्स हैं जो पैथोलॉजिस्ट हैं उनको मालूम होगा ये। हम कहते हैं जैसे आज की डेट में वी आर नॉट केयरिंग कि जो बेसिकली फीमेल हमारे लोग हैं उनको आयरन डिफिशियंसी है। हम कहते हैं हीमोग्लोबिन हमारा इतना है, 14 है, 15 है, लेकिन हीमोग्लोबिन के अंदर भी एक आपका सीरम फेरेटिन है। मैं डॉक्टर नहीं हूं बट मैंने जो हमने रिसर्च करी है, हमारे साथ एक मेडिकल के डॉक्टर्स ने रिसर्च करी, सीरम फेरेटिन कम होता है, आयरन आपका हीमोग्लोबिन बहुत अच्छा होगा, आयरन बहुत अच्छा होगा, बट सीरम फेरेटिन इज डायरेक्टली लिंक्ड विद द आउटकम ऑफ योर एनालिटिकल एबिलिटी। और मैथमेटिक्स एनालिटिकल एबिलिटी को प्रमोट करता है। अगर किसी भी बच्चे के अंदर, हमने क्या किया, हम लोगों ने स्टडी करी अराउंड 60 students पर, हमने क्या किया कि उनका उस बच्चे का हमने ये पैरामीटर, चूंकि हमारे यहाँ फर्स्ट ईयर में जब एडमिशन लेता है बच्चा तो वी आर गोइंग फॉर ए मेडिकल टेस्ट, तो जब मेडिकल टेस्ट हो रहा था तो हमारा जो डॉक्टर था यूनिवर्सिटी का उसने वो पैरामीटर्स मेजर किया। हम लोगों का केवल ये बेसिक पर्पस था कि वी वॉन्ट टू नो कि इस बच्चे के सीरम फेरेटिन इतना है, हीमोग्लोबिन इसका इतना है, आयरन इतना है, तो इसके मैथमेटिक्स में नंबर कितने हैं 10+2 में। इट वॉज सरप्राइजिंग, हमारा जो स्टडी था एकदम फ्लैट आया कि नहीं, जिस बच्चे का ये कम है उसके मैथमेटिक्स में नंबर कम है। हम लोग, बहुत छोटी चीज है ये, आपको पता नहीं लगता है, डॉक्टर्स के पास जाइएगा वो कहेंगे कि देखिए, एक है आयरन डिफिशियंसी और एक है आयरन डिफिशियंसी एनेमिक, हम लोग एनिमिक है, ये है, वो है, ये चीज़ें कर लो, बट जो डिफिशियंसी है, ये हम उन मदर्स को बोलना चाहते हैं, उन गार्जियंस को जो बोलना चाहते हैं कि वो आप भी केयर करें कि आपके बच्चे के अंदर ये चीज़ें हों। और ये इतना मैथमेटिक्स एक ऐसा सब्जेक्ट है, दिस इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव थिंकिंग। ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव थिंकिंग ये ऐसे है कि यू आर कंसेप्चुलाइजिंग ए फ्रेम। आप बायोलॉजी पढ़ते हैं, बायोलॉजी में आपके पास पेड़ होगा, एक बॉडी होगी जिसको आप देख के आप एनालाइज कर सकते हैं कि ये चीज़ ऐसी है, बट मैथमेटिक्स के अंदर एनालिसिस नहीं है। एक आप फ्रेम करेंगे कि ये मैथमेटिकल मॉडल होगा, तो ये ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव थिंकिंग को, ये जो पैरामीटर्स हैं मेडिकल वाले, वो मैं बताना चाहता हूँ आपको कि ये चीज़ें। तो हम समाज में हैं और समाज को हमसे अपेक्षा भी है कि हम इसको लेके जाएंगे। मैथमेटिक्स में जो सबसे पहले जो पार्लियामेंट लगी थी आपकी, दैट वॉज स्पिरिचुअल थिंकिंग पर। अगर आप स्पिरिचुअल हमारी लाइफ, जब भी हम कभी किसी को कहते हैं कि ये बहुत अच्छा लड़का है, बहुत कमजोर है, तो वी आर सेइंग दैट इसका आईक्यू बहुत अच्छा है, आईक्यू बहुत अच्छा है। तो आईक्यू क्या है? इंटेलिजेंट कोशियंट बोलते हैं हम उसको। आप उसको अगर आप उसका फार, वो भी मैथमेटिक्स है, जो अभी आपकी प्रिंसिपल मैडम का ये पूरा क्रिएशन था, इसमें भी मैथमेटिक्स है। कैसे? देखो, स्पिरिचुअल कोशियंट, हमारी लाइफ में तीन कोशियंट होंगे, एक स्पिरिचुअल कोशियंट होगा, एक इंटेलिजेंट कोशियंट होगा, और तीसरा होगा इमोशनल कोशियंट। यहां पर इमोशनल की बात नहीं करी हमने, हमने इंटेलिजेंट, चूंकि मैथमेटिक्स है, इंटेलिजेंट कोशियंट की बात करी है। तो आपका इमोशनल कोशियंट, जो स्पिरिचुअल कोशियंट, इज इक्वल टू इंटेलिजेंट आईक्यू प्लस ईक्यू। इंटेलिजेंट कोशियंट प्लस इमोशनल कोशियंट इज योर स्पिरिचुअल कोशियंट। ये सभी के अंदर होता है, चाहे हमारे देश के नागरिक हों, चाहे इंग्लैंड के हों, चाहे अमेरिका के हों, सबके अंदर एक स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट होता है। इमोशनल कोशेंट बहुत जरूरी है। आपको बताऊं, हम लोग रोबोट को आदमी बनाने की एकदम कगार पर खड़े हैं, केवल और केवल रोबोट के अंदर हम इमोशनल चीजें नहीं डाल पाए अभी तक। हम लोग काम कर रहे हैं उस पर। जिस दिन हमने इमोशंस भी डाल दिया रोबोट के अंदर, उसको ये थिंकिंग होगी, एआई लगा दिया है, बहुत सारी चीज़ें, एआई है, एमएल है, बहुत सारी चीज़ें लगा दिया है, लेकिन इमोशंस हम अभी नहीं दे पाए हैं उसको कि कब उसे रोना है, कब हंसना है, सामने वाले को देख के कब बात करना है, ये चीज़ें अभी बाकी है। तो ये जो आपका स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट है, लोगों को लगता है कि स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट की बात कर रहे हैं। अभी मैं आ रहा था तो जो हमारे साथ आ रहे थे, इन्होंने बुलाया, हमने दो किताबें लिखी हैं, तो मैंने इनकी बोला कि इनकी किताब में, इन्होंने एक एट पावर है, एट पावर इन ए मैन। तो मैंने इनसे पूछा, एट पावर में इन्होंने लिखा था गोल और एक था कॉन्फिडेंस। तो हमने बोला, गोल कैसे स्पेसिफाई करते हो लाइफ में? कभी भी गोल कैसे स्पेसिफाई करते हो आप? मैथ, ये भी इसमें भी मैथमेटिक्स है। तो इन्होंने बताया कि हमने ऐसे ऐसे किया और गोल का कुछ चीज़ें इन्होंने बताया। तो हमने इनको बोला, लाइफ में एक शब्द है स्मार्ट, एवरीबडी इज नोज। हम कहते हैं ये स्मार्ट लग रहा है, ये स्मार्ट कपड़ा पहना हुआ है, नो। स्मार्ट का जो हमारा एब्रीवेशन है, हम लोग जो लड़के को बताते हैं, कोई भी गोल होगा लाइफ में आपके, वो स्पेसिफिक होना चाहिए, किस काम के लिए। जैसे आज हम लोग इस फर्स्ट कंपटीशन पे हैं मैथमेटिक्स से, हमारा गोल स्पेसिफिक है कि हम मैथमेटिक्स को लाइफ में कैसे इनकलकेट करें और कैसे बच्चे को आसान बनाएं मैथमेटिक्स सीखने के लिए। इसका कंपटीशन होगा, इतने पार्टिसिपेंट आए हैं। और जब कभी कोई गोल आप स्पेसिफिकली अचीव करते हैं, तो इट शुड बी मेजरेबल। जैसे मान लीजिए मेरे को चांद पे जाना है, तो मेरे को डिस्टेंस मालूम होनी चाहिए ना, तभी तो हम अपना रास्ता बनाएंगे। तो मेजर, जहां भी मेजरमेंट आएगा, मैथमेटिक्स आई। फिर एस एम ए, ए इज योर अटेनेबल, कितना। अगर ऐसा कोई टास्क भी नहीं होना चाहिए कि जो आप अटेन न कर पाओ, अटेनेबल होना चाहिए, हमारी रीच में होना चाहिए, अदरवाइज हम वो गोल जो है स्मार्ट नहीं हो सकता, नेवर। आर रिलायबल होना चाहिए, जो भी हमारा गोल है उसकी रिलायबिलिटी जो स्टैंड है वो सोसाइटी को स्टैंड करनी चाहिए। और जो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट है, जो हम लैक करते हैं पर्टिकुलरली इन सोसाइटी, दैट इज टू बी टाइम बाउंड। मैं जो हमारे पुराने वाले राष्ट्रपति जी थे कलाम साहब, जिनके नाम से हमारा विश्वविद्यालय भी है, मैं उनका प्रोटोकॉल ऑफिसर रहा एक बार। तो चूंकि जब वो चीफ गेस्ट थे तो मेरे को जाके लेके आना पड़ता था, तो बड़ा अच्छा समय बीतता था उनके साथ। एक मतलब 7-8 घंटे मैं और वो रहते थे, जब उनको छोड़ने गया मैं और मैं उनके साथ रहता था, गेस्ट हाउस में रहते थे। उनका और श्रीधरन साहब जो मेट्रो मैन माने जाते हैं, दोनों लोगों का, कलाम साहब का ये कहना था कि हमने लाइफ में जितने भी प्रोजेक्ट लिए हैं, जितने टाइम में लिया है उतने ही टाइम में हम खत्म करते हैं। श्रीधरन साहब का भी यही था, उन्होंने कहा हमने लाइफ में जितने भी मेट्रो के प्रोजेक्ट बनाए हैं, जितने भी हमने सिविल के प्रोजेक्ट बनाए हैं, अगर हमने कहा 24 महीने में पूरा होगा तो मैंने 22 महीने में पूरा किया। तो दैट इज द टाइम बाउंड। टाइम जब टाइम बाउंड करते हैं फिर वहां मैथमेटिक्स आती है। तो जब भी मैंने आपसे बोला ना कि मैथमेटिक्स को हम स्टडी नहीं करते, मैथमेटिक्स को हम प्रैक्टिस करते हैं, और हम हर जगह पर प्रैक्टिस करते हैं। हम खड़े हैं वहाँ मैथमेटिक्स है, हम अभी बात कर रहे हैं वो भी मैथमेटिक्स है, हमारी जो आवाज़ है वो मैथमेटिकल मॉडल अंदर से जाके इसको पैकेट्स बनाता है, पैकेट्स को आपके तक एम्पलीफायर के थ्रू प्रोपेगेशन करता है। तो ढेर सारी बधाई गांधी सर आपको भी, और मैं सेक्टर जो अलीगंज की ओ सेक्टर ओ में आपकी जो प्रिंसिपल हैं उनका आभार प्रकट करना चाहता हूँ कि मेरे दोनों बच्चे CMS में पढ़े और आज वो अच्छी जगह पर हैं। वो उसके लिए मैं जो आपकी प्रिंसिपल है उनको धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ। और हम लोग जा नहीं पाए और बहुत दिनों के बाद मैं लखनऊ वापस आया हूँ, तो उनका आभार, अगर वो आए हों यहाँ तो नहीं, मेरा आप उनको कन्वे करिएगा। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
I'll take this opportunity to request our respected managing director and president, respected Professor Geeta Gandhi ma'am, to please honor our chief guest, Professor Jay Prakash Pandey. So if we can please have you on stage one more time. Pleasure really to thank Professor Jayaprakash Pandeyji, the honored Vice Chancellor of the AKTU, Abul Kalam Technical University. I understand that from sir that this university, Technical University, has got 758 colleges affiliated to it across the state of Uttar Pradesh. So it's a massive university. I understand it's the biggest university in the state. And to have a person of his stature, his erudition, is really an honor for us to have Professor Pandey here with us this evening. He said maths is all pervasive, all around us, whatever we may be sitting on or whatever we may be seeing, its basis, its fabric, is the original mathematical modeling that was done, which was then converted into equations and then given practical shape in terms of the materials that were used in order to make it. But the basis, the foundation, is indeed mathematics. He spoke about the importance of not only the intelligent quotient,
the sort of IQ, but also of the emotional quotient and also of the spiritual quotient. And he linked the two of them. He talked about Einstein's equation, E equals MC squared, and he gave a very interesting version of the E equals MC squared. E is energy, he said, M is motivation, and C is commitment. So your energy is directly proportional to the amount of motivation that you have, but it is going to be increased by squares each time when you have commitment, because that has a squared term over it. So if your commitment is three times that of somebody else, you will have not three times the energy, but you will have nine times the energy, because you'll have three will be squared. So a very interesting analogy, a bit interesting reflection on how to increase one's own energy. I'll try and use that formula in my own life. He talked about time foundation again, an aspect, important aspect for really success in so many domains, the fact that, you know, we set time parameters and that we keep to them. For example, he gave the example of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, who was a nuclear scientist who went on to become the president of India. So he became, you know, it was a recognition of a scientist by being given the highest honor, the highest post in the country, so to say, that of the being the president of the country. And he was a very time-bound individual. He timed things, and he was so systematic that he managed to achieve things in the time that he had predicted that it should take, or less than that. And similarly, Dr. Sridharan, the Metro Man of India, also time-bound. So he was saying that, in fact, it turns out that being time-bound also centrally involves mathematics. And basically, thank you so much, sir, for your kind presence here and for sharing your thoughts. You know, I don't know what your discipline is, but surely it's a scientific discipline. You spoke about medicine as well. You spoke about the importance of service, how students in your university back in Gorakhpur, how they were doing service to the community, the villages around, you know, measuring hemoglobin, measuring components of the blood, which lead to particular diagnoses, for example, importance of ferritin. So I think that, you know, despite being from a scientific background, you've spoken about a whole range of things which are not necessarily directly scientific, but you've helped us to understand the relevance of mathematics and the pervasive character of mathematics. So thank you so much for your kind presence here. And we were just having a conversation, and I just mentioned in passing, you know, that we are beginning to think about skills development in our school. And he immediately, very generously, absolutely immediately, he said that sign a MOU with us, with our university, and your students can come and use our state-of-the-art laboratories. You know, they've got all the latest equipments and so forth. So such generosity is really quite amazing. Thank you so much, sir, for being here this evening and for sharing the evening with us.
We would like to express a heartfelt thanks to our chief guest for gracing the occasion. We are thankful to Professor Geeta Gandhi Kindan ma'am for her beautiful words and thoughts. Moving ahead in the program, this is a performance that we were waiting for, definitely, because it brings before you the pre-primary and primary section of our campus. We celebrate the vibrant and lively spirit of these youngest learners. We believe that the essence of culture can be beautifully manifested through art of dance.
And what better way to showcase this than through the colorful and energetic Punjabi folk Bhangra. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together as we welcome the adorable students from the pre-primary and primary sections to the stage. These little stars have been eagerly waiting to stomp their feet and sway their tiny hips to the dolls. So without any further delay, let's give them an energetic round of applause to these little performers who are all set to steal your hearts. So, Chakde Fatte, let's welcome them. And we are missing the claps. Yes, come on, audience. Are you ready, children? Here they go.
Anji Badshah, ki dekh rahe ho tusi? Chalo shuru ho jao bhai.
Rajajipuram 2 family. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure we can all agree that this dynamic display of Bhangra has infused our event with joy and energy. These little dancers have not just performed, they have celebrated every step, every beat with untamed enthusiasm. Let's give these incredible young performers another huge round of applause for their outstanding performance. And they deserve all our cheers for their hard work and for spreading such infectious energy among us. Yeah, clap was very less. We can have a huge round of applause. They were students from nursery, KG, class 3 and 4.
We gather not just in body, but in spirit, as we embark on a serene and sacred journey, a journey that recognizes the myriad paths laid out by different faiths, all converging at the doorstep of the Almighty. So let us unite our hearts and souls in the all-religion prayer. We will here witness the harmonious convergence with the diverse chants, hymns, prayers, which although varied in language and tradition, resonate with the same divine essence of love, peace, and compassion. They exemplify beautifully how every faith is a river flowing into the vast ocean of the spiritual oneness. Let's embrace the wisdom each religion pours into our lives, and allow these prayers to guide us close to the divine truth that we all seek. Let us prepare to lift our spirits in this collective enunciation of blessings as we remember that the different paths we walk in their conquest to reach the Almighty.
धन, ये कीर्ति, ये वैभव सब मिथ्या है, यह जान ले। जन्म ही तेरा सत्य है, जन्मा है जिसने, बस उसे पहचान ले। तू ईश्वर को जान ले, बस उसे पहचान ले।
गुरु माँ, ये ईश्वर कौन है?
तुम्हें ईश्वर को जानना है तो आओ मेरे साथ, मैं तुम्हें ईश्वर के विभिन्न रूपों के दर्शन कराती हूँ। मात पिता की सेवा करना, वचन को प्राण समान समझना, नारी के सम्मान को रखना, मर्यादा का तत्व समझना, श्री राम के आदर्श यही हैं, सीखो इन आदर्शों पर चलना। रामायण है राम की वाणी, इस वाणी को हृदय से सुनना।
जय सिया राम,
जय सिया राम, जय जय सिया राम, जय सिया राम, जय जय सिया राम। वही मन का मन का राम नाम की मन बाबाए रे।
सांसों की डोरी में घूमे धीर बंधाए रे। जय राम,
जय राम,
जय राम,
जय राम,
जय राम,
जय राम।
का मेला प्राणों के पन घट का मेला, नैनों की यमुना कारेला, ये अलबेला गीत मीत बन प्रीत जगाए रे। सांसों की डोरी में घूमे धीर बंधाए रे। जय राम,
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 जय राम।
नवाज के हमें जिंदगी अल्लाह ने खूब अता फरमाया है। ए इंसान, न रखो फासले दरमियां, यही सबक मेरे मोहम्मद ने सिखाया है। लफ्जों में कहा दम, जो कह दूं मैं नबी की शान में, सब कुछ तो लिख दिया है अल्लाह ने कुरान में।
ताजदारे हरम हो, निगाहे करम, हम गरीब गरीबों के दिल भी संवर जाएंगे ताजदारे हरम ताजदारे हरम तुमसे कहूँ ऐ रब के कुंवर तुम जान तो मन की बतियां दार फुरकत तो आए उम्मीद लकब का देना कटती अब रतियां तोरी प्रीत में सुध बुध सब बिसरी कब तक रहेगी ये बेखबरी कहे विघ दुस दीदा नजर कभी सुन भी चलो हमारी बतियां आपके दर से कोई न खाली गया अपने दामन को भर के सवाली गया हबीबे हजी ओ हबीबे हजी पर भी आका नजर मरना आरा के हस्ती बिखर जाएंगे ताजदारे हरम ताजदारे हरम मैं कशाओ मदीने चले साकी ये कौसर से पीने चले
दस्त साकी ये कौसर से पीने चले
ताजदारे हरम ताजदारे हरम
वाहे गुरु
नानक नीच कहे विचार वारिया ना जावा एक बार जो तुद भावे साई भली कार तू सदा सलामत निरंकार सच में तू पुण्य में तू पावे तुझको जो करे त्याग तू सबक सीख ले जीवन का सुन गुरु ग्रंथ साहब का मधुर राग नानक नाम चढ़ दी कला तेरे पाणे सर्वत दा भला
ओकड़ बच्चिया नेड़े आन न दिंदे जी नाम दा गेड़ा मन अपने चो लाण न दिंदे जी नाल नाल चल दे नेरा पट कौन न दिंदे जी सतगुरु प्यारे सतगुरु प्यारे गुरुआ ने है दसिया के सदा वंड के खाईदा वंड के खाईदा बेसमझा दे मन अंदर हो सोची पौंदे ने सतनाम ही सतनाम दा जाप करौंदे ने मन्ने ताई सुजाके गूंगे बोलन लौंदे सतगुरु प्यारे सतगुरु प्यारे सतगुरु प्यारे सतगुरु प्यारे सतगुरु प्यारे सतगुरु प्यारे
जहां प्रेम का सागर सदा बहता है वही जगह है जहां यीशु मेरा रहता है परस्पर प्रेम में मगन हो जाओ बस यही प्रभु मेरा कहता है प्रभु प्रेम मिलन की सारी कथा मिलती बाइबल के पृष्ठों पर जो समझन हार वो समझ गया वही पहुंचा जीवन के उत्कृष्टों पर
वंद
देना करके हैं हम वंदना करके हैं हम हृदय को तेरे सामने लाकर रखते हैं हम वंदना करके
इस बात को अपमान समझ बैठे कि गरीब कैसे खुद को इंसान समझ बैठे। समझा नहीं कोई मगर एक ही जमीन एक ही है सबका आसमां। सिखाया बुद्ध ने सबको सभी हैं एक सबका एक ही है जहां।
सूरज जब पलके खोले मन बुद्धं शरणं बोले। कोई ना ऊंचा कोई ना नीचा बुद्ध की वाणी बोले। सूरज जब पलके खोले मन बुद्धं शरणं बोले।
नमो नमो बुद्धाय बोलो नमो नमो बुद्धाय। नमो नमो बुद्धाय बोलो नमो नमो बुद्धाय।
बुद्ध प्रकाश है बुद्ध है मंथन। बुद्ध शरण में जीवन है चंदन।
बुद्ध शरण में जीवन है चंदन।
बुद्ध आलाप है बुद्ध है सुमिरन। बुद्ध है कोमल प्यार का बंधन।
बुद्ध है कोमल
शुद्ध चित्त वालों को झुलाता आनंद में हिंदोले। सूरज जब पलके खोले मन बुद्धं शरणं बोले।
नमो नमो बुद्धाय बोलो नमो नमो बुद्धाय। नमो नमो बुद्धाय बोलो नमो नमो बुद्धाय।
अगर तुम्हें अपने धर्म का जरा भी इल्म होता तो किसी बेगुनाह पर तुम्हारा न जुल्म होता। धर्म धर्म की लड़ाई में किसी को कुछ नहीं मिलता। हृदय को प्रेम से भर लो सभी है ईश्वर हर जगह बसता।
तू मेरा सर्वोच्च लक्ष्य और
तुम्हें पता चला कि ईश्वर कौन है?
अब मुझे सब समझ में आ गया। ईश्वर एक है, उनके रूप अनेक हैं। ईश्वर अल्लाह वाहेगुरु, चाहे कहो श्री राम। मालिक सबका एक है, अलग अलग है नाम।
ईश्वर अल्लाह वाहे गुरु, चाहे कहो श्री राम। मालिक सबका एक है, अलग अलग है। सबका एक है, अलग अलग है नाम।
मालिक सबका एक है, अलग अलग
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, what we have just experienced is a profound testament to the fact that the highest of all teachings, the core of every religion, is humanity itself. Today, through the mingling voices of prayer, we were reminded that our individual faiths, no matter how different, all aspire to nurture the light of love and human kindness within us. Let us carry forth the message of today's all religion prayer, that we all are but the leaves on the same tree of life, blossoming through the nurturing rays of humanity. May this understanding permeate our action, fostering respect and unity among us all. Let the reverences for every path to the divine continue to grow in our hearts, for it is through humanity that we embody the greatest truth of our respective beliefs.
We're about to start a very special time together with our unity prayer. Picture this majestic globe as we stand, an emblem of the diverse yet interwoven threads of humanity. Soon, students from all over the place, from Asia's quiet grasslands to Asia's busy cities, from old Europe to lively North and South America, and the warm islands in the Pacific to the cold Antarctica, we'll say a prayer together, asking for us to be united. These young people, full of hope, will talk about their shared dream of living in a peaceful world. Let's really listen to what they have to say. Let their words touch us and move us to do good things. Their prayers are joining together to become a strong message that can reach across the whole world, bringing friendship and giving us hope that cannot be stopped. Get ready to be moved.
Good evening to all present here. We stand here to beseech you to consider the state of our world that is fragmented by invisible lines and boundaries. These have unnaturally caused divisions, wars, and innumerable losses of innocent lives. Today, let's unify our hearts and share a collective desire for peace and unity. We urge each one present here to do their bit to dissolve these divisions, letting the artificial borders remain only on our maps and not in our hearts. Unity, guided by love and harmony, is the prime directive to a fair world government and not divisions.
Together, let's strive for a united world under a single governance, operating not on power but on love. With this plea, we present before you the unity prayer.
Thank you.
ايش اللي صار يا حاج؟ ايش اللي صار؟
قاعدين
بنخبز
ما في ولا
حاجه
بنخبز
للناس
المجانين في شقاره ولا ميه.
والله ما عاد بيعرف ايش صار. والله ما عاد بيعرف كلهم قريب من بندور لعائلات تينا. مالنا غيرك يا رب. يا رب قتل اطفال يا رب والله يا رب حذرونا.
Civilizations throughout the ages are fraught with savage internecine warfare. The 20th century saw two world wars, the Nazi Holocaust, the bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The 21st century began reeling under the fear of a third world war, a nuclear holocaust. Challenges today's world is facing due to the after effects of the pandemic, the ongoing Ukraine-Russia war, and heinous wars like terrorism in Israel and Gaza. The situation in the world is grim, scary, and dangerous. Wars have catalyzed more deadly arms. Wars begin in the minds of men. Thus, in the minds of men that the defenses of peace have to be. Mahatma Gandhi said, if we are to teach real peace in this world, and if we are to carry on a real war against war, we shall have to begin with the children. Let us pray for a world where differences are not sources of division, but wellsprings of learning and growth.
To make this earth a paradise of truthful souls. May we fervently pray that we become the leading voice to protect humanity. May we seek a change of heart and renewed mindset. Lord, give us the courage to live our faith boldly and consistently. Dear God, fill the hearts with your spirit of love and unity among believers across this world. I stand in peace and act as a benevolent presence amid turmoil. I am the agent of peace, a divine being who brings peace in every situation. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they are the children of God.
Lord, help the people of North America to find the faith in the midst of the chaos. Give them the desire and ability to see you, hear you, talk to you, and give thanks to you. We pray that they will draw nearer and nearer to you all their life. It's time to make peace. It finds an echo in the sky-high rooftops of the modern cities of North America. The kindred of land must come together to raise the standard of unity to the skies so that a shiny light is visible from Canada to Mexico.
I believe that all people are equal and that education is the key to promoting unity and brotherhood among the people of different races and backgrounds. In the spirit of truth, honesty and fairness, all men are created equal.
May unity prevail on earth. I pray for the people of North America. May unity prevail in North America. May unity prevail on earth.
Europe, one of the world's most varied continents in the terms of culture, history, and geographical diversity. From verdant mountain ranges and lush countryside to crystalline coastlines and Arctic sceneries, it contains hundreds of UNESCO World Heritage Sites, thousands of beautiful corners, and too much natural beauty to soak in one lifetime. Europe is a continent with a long, fascinating, and extremely important history of human development and considered as the birthplace of Western civilization. But today, Europe is facing multiple crises that affects its economy, security, and society. The influx of refugees and migrants from war-torn and persecuted countries, which poses humanitarian and integrational challenge. Bless and heal the world, Lord. May your love comfort every soul, as only you can bring hope to the hopeless, and unity where there is conflict.
I believe in the importance of education and power of knowledge to promote unity and equality among all people. O Lord, bless and heed this world.
May unity prevail on earth. I pray for the people of Europe. May unity prevail in Europe. May unity prevail on earth.
Than colors and higher than words. The angels of heaven proclaim praises to the incomparable beauty of South America. The colorful carnivals, the exciting football matches and the mesmerizing moves of the samba make up the collage of South America, the fourth largest continent in the world. But in the recent past, South America recorded the largest deterioration in peacefulness, which was driven by deteriorations on militarization and safety and security. God, you see us, you hear us, you are good and you are fair. Prepare our hearts, Lord, go before us. Repair our wreckage, bless and empower us with spirit-fueled confidence. Lord of our hearts, may all we do bring glory and honor to you. As shrouds of light piercing the darkness,
I believe that mathematics can help to promote understanding and cooperation among the people of different cultures and backgrounds. I have always worked to promote educational opportunities for women and girls.
I pray for the people of South America. May unity prevail in South America. May unity prevail on earth.
Repository of culture, traditions, and ecological adaptations. Oceania is the home to the world's most diverse range of indigenous cultures, as all humans have been created in the image of God. God does not make any distinctions between people, regardless of race or color. All humans have been created equal. They are required to equal opportunities and treatment. Oh Lord, help us who today remember the cost of war to work for a better tomorrow. And as we commend to you lives lost in the terror and conflict, bring us all in the end to the peace of your presence.
This work is hard but not impossible. Lord, may we be a witness to many miracles in our lives and sing of the glory and honor. Bless our lives with truth and love. Lead us and be with us.
May unity prevail on earth. I pray for the people of Oceania. May unity prevail in Oceania. May unity prevail on earth.
The second largest continent, covering about one-fifth of the total land surface of Earth, remains the center of attraction when it comes to peace, mainly due to its glaring underdevelopment. On the contrary, many African countries are still experiencing high political instability, wars, corruption, and economic stagnation. And these factors threaten their peace and the beautiful continent of Africa faces the unfortunate challenge of having become the epicenter of terrorism and violent extremism. Oh Lord, motivate us by love to work together and embolden us to obey your direction. While our world is crumbling, you remain the same, loving, defending and protecting Father.
Dear God, our Almighty, hear our prayers for all who strive for peace and all who fight for justice, for rights of minority groups and equality among all people.
May unity prevail on earth. I pray for the people of Africa. May unity prevail in Africa. May unity prevail on earth.
We worship and adore you. We thank you for all the blessings that you have given us, for walking with us every day and for being with us in each moment. O loving and gracious Creator, your love embraces all members of the human family. Your care extends to the least of those among us. To all our brothers and sisters in every part of the earth, God of compassion, walk alongside of all the global stewards who work to create more just and peaceful world. That let your will be done. Teach the world's leader to forgive, to extend welcome across borders. Show the world a new path beyond greed, oppression, and division. Bless all our efforts towards uniting peoples and nations. Grant us the wisdom and grace to become a true global family and witness your reign on this earth. May unity among the nations proliferate as strengths. The time to unite is here. This is the age in verily most great peace will be established on earth. The heart of men will be together as one, and the pain of one will be the agony of all. May unity and peace prevail on earth. May unity and peace prevail on earth.
May unity and peace prevail on earth.
May unity
powerful message of unity and hope that has been shared. The voices of our friends representing every corner of our beautiful planet have reminded us of the urgent need for harmony and understanding in our world today. Let us carry with us the spirit of unity that has been ignited within our hearts. Let us remember the power of coming together, putting aside our differences, and working towards a common goal for peace and prosperity for all. May the prayers and aspirations that have been expressed here today continue to reverberate in our thoughts and actions. Let us be inspired to be the change we wish to see in the world. And let us strive to create a future where tolerance, compassion, and respect reign supreme.
I stand here today on behalf of entire team of City Montessori School, Rajajipuram Campus 2, to express my heartfelt gratitude for gracing this occasion and being a source of immense encouragement and support. It fills us with great joy and honor to have our esteemed individuals present here today. First of all, I would like to thank all the principals of CMS and HODs to be here after such a long, tiring day. I really thank, ma'am, I'm really grateful that you all are there and still, and till the end of the program, you all are sitting and watching the program. So, Matheletics and an event dedicated to the celebration of mathematics, like I said in my welcome speech as well. It would have not been possible without the visionary leadership and guidance of our respected founders, Managing Director and President, and Head QAID and Superior Principal, Ms. Sushmita Ghosh. We would also like to thank all the team who has joined here, the principals, director and team leaders of 12 international, 22 national and 27 local teams. Once again, thank you all for gracing us the occasion and your presence. Thank you so much.
जन जन मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंधु गुजरात मराठा द्राविड़ उत्कल बंग विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जलधि तरंग तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे जन जन मंगलदायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता